Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play Scooby Doo
Night 100 Frights.
With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off. We clambered over some rooftops and mount balconies and stuff, and today we're gonna go in here and trigger the first boss battle by the looks of it, so we'll see how it goes. Oh god. Hey, how you doing?
Ah, the infamous Scooby Doo.
Ah, it's even Mastermind behind this.
I am the Mastermind.
Oh, okay. Booga 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 booga.
I'm the reason you're here.
You are?
I'm Why? The one who made Professor Graham disappear.
Who did?
Disappear.
I'm also the one who's brought back all of your old foes.
How do you know about... Yeah, exactly, why?
That is a mystery you will never solve. And one more thing. I'm the one who's kidnapped all your friends.
But why? What's the point?
Velma!
Hello, Velma.
Scooby-Doo!
See if you can get past this fiendish fright. You remember the Black Knight.
Oh, the Black Knight. I've never actually seen the episode with the Black Knight. I remember having on video, Velma, was the one with the faceless zombie.
We'll worry about that later, Scooby. Watch out! It's the Black Knight!
That's the one I remember most, the faceless zombie. Hey, how you doing? I must ask you a question, Squire. There you go. How many times do I have to hit this guy? Is it like the usual stereotypical boss move? Bullshit! Come on.
Rummy.
There you go, bad guy. So if it's not 3, then normal boss battle dictate is going to be 5. Oh, I've got to get him to land on each of them. Okay, I see. There we go, did I get him? Oh! Bloody audio blast, man. Shit, I'm gonna fix this, actually. Jesus, it's like blasting my ears out, man. It's been alright for the first few. Because it was okay for like the first for the first few episodes. It just seems to be getting louder and louder every episode. And not, I don't know, it's just annoying. How do we get Velma out? Oh!
My glasses! Help me look for them, Scooby.
Okay.
We're okay.
Something fishy's going on here, Scooby. We solved the mystery of the Black Knight ages ago. Have you found any clues?
No.
I don't know. There was a spooky groundskeeper.
A spooky groundskeeper?
I think he's an asshole, to be honest.
And ghosts and monsters.
Scooby-Doo, you know there's no such thing as monsters and ghosts.
The
first time we met the Black Knight, we thought he was a monster, but really he was just a guy in a mask.
But I just electrocuted the shit out of that other guy, so...
Jinkies, the lenses got knocked out.
Where's some lenses, Velma?
Thanks, Scooby. I can't see anything without these. Jinky, Scooby, it's the Creeper!
The Creeper? Where?
He's everywhere! Run, Scooby!
Velma, what? Wait!
It's something on her lenses, like.
I don't see any Creeper.
And even if it was, there's like... We'd be able to bash its head in.
There.
Hello, television.
Hello.
I'm Professor Alexander Graham. And you are my amazing. Let's see now. What's in this one? Here we go. Well, inside this box,
sticky shoes.
My automated herring scraper or my anti-stick galoshes. Oh, looks like it's the galoshes. With these, you can walk across any sticky surface and not get stuck. And
give me those oak boots.
They're banana flavored. Oh, banana. My favorite.
Banana bean! Why would you have banana flavored shoes? Okay. So, I'll show you how to work these. Okay, let's just go get this anyway. Oh, we're already full up on health. So we don't need to go through there just yet, but I'll show you how these work really quickly. It's like, when you come onto a... Yeah, we'll save it now. When you come to a surface which you normally would be able to jump on, the boots activate and you can now jump on this surface, okay? So you can walk up and down this surface, which is extremely useful because it allows to backtrack and stuff like that. So what I'm going to do with this series is actually is I'm going to... just go through the game as normal, as if I was just playing by normally. Collect as many Scooby snacks as possible. Collect as many Scooby snacks as possible. There we go, that one. Collect as many Scooby snacks as possible on the way, but once I get all the gadgets towards the end of the game, I think I'll, from there, that's when I'll, what's the word I'm looking for? From then, that's when I'll, come on, Scooby. From then, that's when I shall...
Ruby snacks.
That's when I shall, continue on and... Well, I'll backtrack and get all the rest of the Scooby snacks and monster tokens, because... Because it's all fun and games me, like, saying I'm going to get all the Scooby snacks along the way, but... It's going to be difficult to remember where they all are, so it's best if I go through the game at least once and then just continue on as if I've...
Alright! It's a headless specter!
Bollocks. Then just continue on once I've got other gadgets. I think that's going to be a lot more easier. Okay, so let's just... Yeah, but yeah, that's just how I'm going to handle this series. If you've got any objections, then I'd apologise, but I'm sure you guys really don't mind either way. So let's get to the warp gate. Use the warp gate. Because I remember there being a... I got a way around. That's good. But I need the umbrella by the looks. I remember there being a... Is there any areas, like... I think where we've got to go is we've got to go into Smuggler's Cove. And there was an area... Not activated. Okay, so let's just warp here. Because I remember there being a tower place where you needed to jump over barrels and stuff, so... And I've also noticed that, like, here... That I've not got all the Scooby Snacks in Mystery Machine. Which I can do, I'm just missing a few Scooby Snacks from there, so... So let's quickly save and continue on. Oh, excuse me. What on earth am I supposed to be doing here? Okay. Oh. This is like a place that... I'll just get all the Scooby Snacks to have a quick explore around, but... It's looking like it's going to be a platforming thing, so... Actually, just having the... Oh my Jesus. But I can't charge on this, so... He's got a distinct advantage over me. Can I jump on this thing? No, I need the head smash. Okay. So what is it? So what is it similar to? Excuse me. What is it similar to now? Actually, it's. Yeah. It's actually quite similar to what's that game where you like learn skills? Similar to Spyro, where you learn skills as you go along, but.
There we go.
What monster was that? I don't remember seeing this Scooby episode. But it's oh, come on, Scooby. You can get around there. Oh, I forget. Just take the death. I want that Scooby snack down there, though. So screw these guys. So it's pretty obvious where they are, because normally they... Oh, maybe it's not. Hey, over here. Why is this... Or is it a she? Because it's got a very high-pitched voice, I suppose. Okay. God, screw this. This is going to be a freaking pain in the ass to get around. Especially with these two down here. Wow. Well, I get the feeling that this room's going to be a pain in the ass, so I'll do a speed run of me getting over the conveyors. Oh, come on! Minute! Oh my Jesus Christ! That was a pain in the ass! Jesus Christ! I'm looking forward to going back here with a gadget which lets me use the charge on actual slippery surface, because that is difficult. That was the most difficult platform I've had to do in this game for a while. Okay, but yeah. It's looking like it's starting to ramp up in difficulty now, so the Scooby Snacks may be having to take a back seat, because like, up until now it's been pretty simple just collecting all these Scooby Snacks as I go along, but But it's just, it's become one of those things where it's, wow. Okay, where do I want to go? There's a lift over here. Oh, there's also a key down here. That is cool. That is cool that they make you go all the way over there thinking that you're not supposed to be. That is very cool game. But you put a key down here when, like, they make you go all the way across making you think that, oh, there's not. Oh, all the keys are going to be along the way. Nope. There's a key down right on the floor. That is very cool, I've got to say. God. See, the rules of, like, platforming games, like, of this ilk, like, and this age in general, like, the normal rules are that, like, follow the shadow, like, you're going to land where the shadow is, so. But, like, with this game, it doesn't give you much time to react to the shadow actually manifesting on the floor. So, I don't know, it's just, it just seems really difficult sometimes. Wait, am I just back up to where I started? Need four keys to unlock this door. Oh, there's only one over there. Okay, see if we can just collect as many Scooby Snacks as possible. It's gonna make it more difficult for me in future. Oh, I forgot about the standing still rule. Bloody hell. And that was so difficult before. What a pain. Okay. I completely forgot about the standing still rule. God damn it. That other room could have been so much easier as well. I'm so annoyed by that. Can I smash this? God. And like I said there, I thought it was some sort of glitch as well, but it might not be a glitch, you know. It might just be the way that the game handled that. The ability to have buttons on this floor, but also make it a pain to kill all the monsters. We'll see. So I'm missing one key. No, you're not. Stupid thing. One annoying monster's like, nya, 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 nya. Oh, shut up, man. You irritating thing. So what's up on this lift? I wonder if there's any monster tokens lying around, like. Do we get some monster tokens? Oh, we know.
Right. Crabs!
I love how crabs can damage your health. It's like the first monster in this key. Does anyone remember what's it called? The King Kong game. Like the one that was based on that film. I really enjoyed that film. It's like I don't know why, it just struck a chord with me. It was like just I just found it to be a really, really good game. It's like especially like when it sort of stripped back the heads-up display. You know how you've got games which tells you all the ammunition you've got and stuff like that? I think you've got the option to put that on in King Kong, but in this instance, like, the one that I played, like, you had to press a button where you check the magazines you got and how much ammunition you got. So, like, your character would say so many magazines on backup or whatever, and how many bullets he's got left, so I don't know, it was just like It was kind of refreshing to have the HUD stripped back, and like, and I feel that should be a thing with some horror games. Like, I was thinking about horror games the other day. I'm like, horror games have always got like suspenseful music. I'm like, that's fair enough, like, cause it adds atmosphere, but would it be more immersive if they got rid of any sort of music in the background, or like it was just background audio? Like, if he was in a scary, in a dark forest, you just hear noise of a dark forest, like, you know, the wind, any particular animals that are around at the time, like the rustling of the leaves. Would that be more atmospheric? Because sometimes stone cold silence is scarier than building an atmosphere, I find. Okay, so let's go and deal with anything that's down here. Of which I assume there are many fish things. Scary fish monsters. You can hear them, but like, there we go. It's almost like they're making two sounds at the same time. Like, they're making the laughy sound, like, I'm gonna get you, and they're also going, yeah, 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 in the background as well. So, I've got everything down here. God, it would have been so much easier if I just got all the Scooby snacks on before. But, oh well. I know the tricks now. I know the tricks of a trade, so. But yeah, what percent am I? I'm only on 30-odd%, so like, it's definitely slowing down a lot. I think, well, I don't want this episode to take well over 20 parts. I definitely don't want it to get up to the 30 part marker, because I think that would be a bit overkill. But like I said, I've never completed this game before, so I don't know how long it's going to be. I'm estimating between 20 and 30 parts at the current pace. But like I say, that's me going off how long to beat, because I've never completed this game before, so I can't tell you when the end of the game is. Okay. Well, this platform's simple, just go for the middle. Then you can't put a foot wrong, really. Oh, bloody Nora! Come back to you when I get up there. Okay, so I made it. Let's go through here. See what's through here. Probably more bosses and stuff. Like, I'm not sure how many bosses there are. Like, rules dictate it'd be between 3 and 5, you would have thought. You just keep jumping coming down and you get all the Scooby snacks. Okay, just get the last of the Scooby snacks. Which is this one. Okay, put it here. See, this one's a bit more simple than the other one, because it's like, hey, I jumped on that fish, did I not? Because, like, all you gotta do is just follow the thing around. And then you can collect all the Scooby snacks, so it's like the conveyor belts in this instance are working in your favour. Unless you go and do that. Okay, see if there's any Scooby snacks down here. Of which there most certainly is, so we shall get all these Scooby snacks, but yeah. But like I said, I don't want the series to go over 30 parts, because, because like I said at the start, it was going to be between this and Persona 3. Bollocks. Like, it was going to be between this and Persona 3. Come on, Scooby. Like, it was going to be between this and Persona 3 FES, but with Danganronpa already underway, I think with Persona 3 FES, it would have been two huge games alongside each other, and that would have just caused a whole world of trouble. Mainly with Channel Variety, but I think I would have remedied that by doing, like, not a third series, but just, like, random gameplays. Like you saw what I did with the random Yu-Gi-Oh! Video. Like, I thoroughly enjoy, like, playing on Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro and just, like, you know, not necessarily going up against other people, just, oh, come on, how could you slide off there? Not necessarily going up against other people, but, like, I find enough of a challenge going up against AI for now, but we'll see how I feel about that. Am I just going to have to keep doing this? Okay, I'll go back to you when I get across. Oh, we got to Orb Gate. And you know what that means? That means I'm out of time for this episode as well, so next episode we'll just continue on. And then hopefully just click some more Scooby Snacks, click some more monster tokens, and just continue on. So thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.